Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe.
Very special evening tonight. She's not only our MC, but also one of the models of philanthropy. This is her second season with us. Walking the Runway. Rita Cosby is a familiar face to many of you. She is a renowned Emmy-winning TV host and multiple best-selling author who is heavily engaged in many major philanthropic efforts and is always fashionable. So she is the perfect person to MC our event. Everyone, please give a big round of applause for my friend, Rita Cosby.
Yeah!
Good evening, everybody. Oh my God, the bar. You guys had more than an hour of the bar. You gotta be louder than that. First of all, I wanna welcome everybody. This is the best New York Fashion Week event, don't you think? Because it's all for a great cause. We have some of the best designers. We actually have two who are making their debut tonight. And I can't wait, they're so awesome and such wonderful people. And I saw some amazing designs backstage. So you guys are all in for a real, real treat. We also have some really beautiful models and also the models of philanthropy, which I'm very proud to be a part of also tonight, because this is all for an amazing cause and it's all about making a difference. I also want to give a big shout out, Yvonne, thank you for the beautiful introduction of Absolute Modern. Thank you, my friend.
Welcome back, darlings. I'm Cognac Willa-Lane, and I am here with the coordinator of this event for the Rick Galvin, Carol Galvin Foundation and Fashion Show, Ms. Yvonne Camacho. And she coordinated this wonderful event.
I worked with Rick. This is our second show together. And we plan on doing a lot more shows. He's wonderful to work with and organized and passionate. And I work with a lot of people, but I'm going to tell you, I'm going to stop working with a lot of people. He's fantastic. And it's a great fundraiser.
It's a wonderful cause.
Oh, and it's cancer. We're expecting 300 people tonight.
300 people?
I don't know if we're going to fit everybody.
Oh, my God. Well, yes. I'm glad we're here tonight, and I came early to do my interviews, and you look spectacular. I'm having a great time
so far. Oh, wonderful, wonderful.
Yes. Yeah. So tell us a little bit more about, you know, how you hooked up with Rick.
Actually, Rick found me. He knew I do luxury events. I have a wonderful client, Avadurmi Mooney.
I just interviewed her.
Designs these bags, which are so beautiful. Yes. And I have another business partner, Lorraine Silvitz, and I wanted to do bags for luxury women. And Lorraine said, let's call it Models of Philanthropy. And so we got some of the most beautiful women. Mitzi Perdue, did you interview Mitzi? You have to interview Mitzi. Rita Cosby. We have Carissa Lawson of Anchor News. Janelle Tana, who's a beautiful actress. And it's been phenomenal. And people, all the women want to walk. We can only have a certain amount of women. And it's raising money for a great cause. My mother passed away from cancer. Rick's mother passed away from cancer.
I know.
So it means a lot. So it's a good feeling.
It's a great feeling. And I'm glad we're here tonight. Tell my audience, where can we go to learn more information about you? Absolute Modern.
You could go to my Instagram, which is at Absolute Modern. You could also go to Avadurmi Mooney. She has her blog. I'm all up on there. And a lot of her bags are on Etsy. And you can contact me directly, and you can tell her, and she'll get a hold of me. We do a lot of events, and they're wonderful, and we're excited. Thank you so much, darling.
We'll be back, darlings, with more interviews right here at New York Fashion Week. Keep watching Pink Champagne Kisses. Welcome back, darlings. I'm Cognac Willa Lane, and I am here with this fabulous designer, Avadora, and it's all about the handbag. Avadora, tell my audience how long you've been designing handbags.
Well, this
luxury handbags.
Well, our bags, this is our second launch. We've been working on this since 2017, and here we are again with new things to show our audience.
Just gorgeous. So how many bags are in the collection that we're going to see this evening?
There's 17 bags total, and there's the new project, which is created with real gems that I'm holding here. So we have a variety of semi-precious stones between citrine, ametrine, lemon quartz. We do have an emerald.
Gorgeous.
So, yes.
They are really incredible.
Thank you.
Bags, really, really incredible. And so much. How long does it take to make a bag like this?
This one took me about a month to put together. It's really where the stone falls and how the setting allows me to keep making these one-of-a-kind items.
What inspired you to create this, these fascinating, glamorously fascinating and gorgeous handbags? Something must have triggered it.
Yes. Well, I was always a very introverted child back in Portugal in the Azores, and I had a really hard time expressing myself in such a close community at the time that I always wanted to stand out and sparkle and do something different. So I've always collected stones and sparkly things at the beach and try to create things with, and I'm so fortunate to be here in New York and being able to put these beautiful one-of-a-kind items together.
I can't wait to see the show. Tell my audience, where can we go to learn more information about your very beautiful, glamorous bags, handbags?
Well, I'm
they're all they're evening bags, right?
Well, we just launched it with the teens. They can be worn with jeans, and they can be worn with a blazer, a gown. I mean, they're very versatile. You can find me on all over social media, Avadurmi Mooney Collection, and I'm represented by Yvonne Camacho from Absolute Modern. She's our representative, and
she did a spectacular job tonight with this event. Very nice.
Well, not only Yvonne is one of my, she's my best friend. She's a phenomenal woman, and she works really hard. And
oh, you don't have to tell me. I know she works very hard.
She's absolutely amazing. So here we are.
Terrific. One more time, the website.
Avadurmi Mooney Collection. We do have some bags on Etsy. Avadurmi Mooney on Etsy. And that's...
Can we follow you on Instagram?
Avadurmi Mooney.
Gorgeous. Darlings with more interviews right here during New York Fashion Week. Keep watching Pink Champagne Kisses.
Together, together. for showing up and helping support the foundation and to listening to this speech that I have.
Welcome back, darlings. I'm Cognac Willa Lane, and we are here at the Rick Galvin Charity Foundation and Fashion Show. And I'm here with the founder himself, Mr. Rick Galvin. Tell my audience about this event this evening. What can we expect?
We're going to expect some interesting things and some great designers. We have three designers tonight. We have starting off is going to be Avedore Mimini with their luxury purses and the Models of Philanthropy, which people like Rita Cosby, Mitzi Perdue, and others that are walking for her. And then we have Kayshawn, and it's his mannequin mob line, which is he's been featured on VH1's Housewives of or Basketball Housewives, I believe. And then we have a new lingerie line by Sarah Minervini, which is her line's called Sirs Lingerie. So we're excited to debut that here at New York Fashion Week. We have a special performance by the Brooklyn Interdenominational Choir. And also, of course, my client Meredith O'Connor will be performing with them as well. And we have many other different types of surprises. So we have some fun and some dancers that are going to do some pretty cool stuff.
Well, it sounds like a whole lot of fun. And it's right here during New York Fashion Week. Yeah. Now, tell my audience about the Carol Galvin Foundation. What is that really all about?
Okay. So when I was younger, I lost my mom to cancer.
Did she have breast cancer?
She had a non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, which actually, you know, back then was not very curable, but nowadays it's one of the more curable cancers, which is unfortunate. But so she passed away when I was 11, and I was supposed to be there the night she passed, but I didn't, and it was a decision I always regretted. And then, so I tried to make it up to her through doing different things, and finally I came to starting this foundation about 10 to 11 years ago now. And I used to just donate directly to like a Susan G. Komen or a Bright Pink and just giving them money for research. And then about 7 years ago, I decided to make it more personal. So now what we do is we sponsor women directly and anyway, women that are battling cancer. And all, the money we raise, we donate directly to them so they could pay their bills, maybe
and
go on a trip.
And that's what this fashion show is about.
Yes.
Am I right about that?
Yeah, absolutely. So, I mean, it's great with the entertainment
and
all
the
that. The fashion and all that stuff, that's great.
But it's really for that this particular cause.
Yes, and that's why a lot of the people that come on board and help out have been really good. I have a lot of people that are volunteering, and not paying or without being paid, and just donating their time and energy, which means a lot to me because I know it's not always easy to do that for people. So that means a lot to me, and so many people like Sid Rosenberg from Sid, Bernie and Sid Show in the morning. He's come out. He's going to MC a little bit of the VIP hour we have going on. He brought me on his show this morning to do an interview. He's been great. So, I was on Joe Piscopo also as well. So it's been, the people that have just helped.
Is this your first charity gala, or have you had many?
No, I've been doing about 8-9 years. This is my 7th year with New York Fashion Week.
Okay. I've never been to your event. This is very nice.
Oh, yeah. I hope you have fun. I hope you'll experience it and want to keep coming back because, we always like to see
new faces.
New faces, and I like to see the familiar faces. So we have John Sinise also. I don't want to forget to mention him because he's great. He's an illustrator for DC Comics and Marvel Comics. So he comes here and he draws like Batman and Superman right here in front of you, and he donates portions of his sales back to the foundation. He's going to do an auction tonight as well.
Now this foundation, the proceeds for tonight's event will go towards non-Hodgkin's disease, or will go back into the foundation. How does that work?
Yeah, it's not. It doesn't matter what kind of cancer the women are suffering from. It's just if you're a woman, a mother usually, but it depends on the story that we get. We have people that recommend people and stuff like that. So it depends on whatever cancer they have. We don't worry about what they're really battling with. It's if they're struggling and they need help with, especially like hospital bills or house repairs or whatever it is, we donate that money so they could, relieve a little bit of that stress that they have going on.
I understand. That's wonderful. I have breast cancer.
Oh, no, I didn't know
Yeah,
that.
And I have both my breasts removed. But I told the doctor, I says, you know what? take, I had it in one breast. I said, take them both off and give me bigger ones. And he did.
Well, that's a good doctor.
It was a good doctor. But it's so wonderful that you decided to do this, and a wonderful organization. Well, if we want to learn more information about the real Carol Galvin Foundation, where can we go?
Yeah, so you could go on Instagram and Facebook. On Instagram, it's Carol Galvin _Foundation. You know, I got to make it a little hard for people to find. Don't ask me why. So Carol Galvin _Foundation is our Instagram. In Honor of Carol Galvin is on Facebook, and same with Twitter. It's RG Fight. Yeah, I switch it up on everybody, but Instagram's my more now
active. Where can we follow you, darling?
Same thing on Instagram. I don't remember my Instagram. Rick Galvin 90 something. But if you follow the Carol Galvin Foundation, you'll able to find me from there.
Sounds wonderful. And we kind of match a little bit.
We're looking good.
Yeah,
together.
We're in the pink shade.
Yeah.
Just perfect for breast cancer, because breast cancer is pink. Where everybody wears pink. And we'll be back, darling. Give me a kiss.
Oh,
sure. We'll be back with more interviews right here at the Carol Galvin Foundation Charity Gala and Fashion Show. Keep watching. Peace, champagne, kisses.
Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some of you know Bridget Fardell. Well, now it's time for the Cognac Show. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm a bubbly blonde, fabulously dressed to impress. One of a kind girl. I was brought into this world wrapped up in pearls. I love to mingle, though my husband reminds me I'm not single. I meet and greet both the famous and the elite. I ride in limousines, drinking the finest champagne, wearing furs, dazzling diamond jewelry. A girl can't complain. I live the upscale life, dining in the finest restaurants, eating the best caviar for free. And no matter how much I enjoy cognac, ooh, ooh, I sip cognac, ooh, ooh, ooh.
This has been a Crybaby Productions, darlings.